So, Muse is a new iPad-friendly application designed to be your new workspace. It markets itself as a tool for thought and as a spatial canvas for your research notes, reading, sketches, screenshots, and bookmarks. Today, we are diving into Muse as we do an early look review. This application is out in the wild, but has not been out there for too long. And as a beta tester, I've been playing around with it for a few weeks and wanted to share a few of my thoughts in this review. Before we begin, folks, today's video is sponsored by ClickUp. So folks, this month here on Keep Productive is one of my highly recommended project management tools, and that is ClickUp. Now, ClickUp is one of the fastest growing productivity and project management platforms in the last 2 years, and it's only been around for 2 years. They already have millions of users, and over 100,000 teams are using them at the world's best companies like Google, Airbnb, Uber, and Nike. Now, teams traditionally use spreadsheets, email, chat, and many project managers, but there's a big trend towards teams using just one application. Most teams replace three or more apps just by switching to ClickUp. So that process in itself, moving into one application, saves teams so much time. Now, ClickUp has features like tasks, docs, and goals to keep organized in one place and have fewer meetings, emails, and daily switches between multiple applications. And it's perfect for all types of teams, from 2 to 2,000, and from farming projects to even building aeroplanes. On top of that, they have an extremely generous free forever plan. You can literally add unlimited users and unlimited work to their app for free. So guys, you can find out more about ClickUp below. I recommend checking them out. They also do have a Just Me plan if you wanted to switch to some of your own personal work too. So thanks again to ClickUp for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. Okay, so let's start with the premise behind Muse. So it aims to steer away from Notion and Wiki tools and leave a more open canvas playground for your notes and documents. You can create cards inside of Muse, anything from PDF cards to checklists. And to organize everything, you use what's called boards, which we all know and love, to folderize or projectize everything. There's an action bar below that helps you to access all the goodies, and they state that they believe tools we are currently using have limits to creativity, so they've made navigation one of the easiest elements of this. You can use Muse using your hand on the iPad or use an Apple Pencil that is connected to it. And they do believe Muse is going to be your 3D digital garden. So let's take a look at some of the features. So as I said, it's available for iPad, uses the Apple Pencil, and has some newer iOS 14 features. Features include crafting boards. Now let me bring together a board for a dream garden shed with you guys. As you can see there, it's very creative. What I quite like about it is the gestures and animation are really easy to use, although they do seem to take a little bit of time to learn from the guidebook. It's definitely an enjoyable experience for sure. But something to note here, while the design is minimal, the features work well. It doesn't really blow you away as much as you can think. So let's take a look at pricing. One of the things that doesn't make it better is the $99 per year price tag. This is something a little wild in terms of pricing, but I guess with those who invested in the iPad, this could be a reliable hub. I just can't take myself away from the pricing, as tools like GoodNotes and Notability offer similar experiences at different prices, but obviously much better prices. Now, in terms of the usability, the tool was actually fast and easy to use. I didn't actually have any hiccups or delay. As I said, there's a slight learning curve when you're getting started, but I guess I solved that within 20 minutes of use. It now works with the Magic Keyboard, which is definitely something, if you've got the accessory, that goes a long way. It's actually quite fun to use, but doesn't feel as fun as Notion is to organize. Two features that sort of really impressed me was the inbox feature, which is where you can actually drag a card to the side and sort of capture it for there, so you can move them into other boards for later. And I also like how they exported the PDFs or any of the canvases you created, no matter how the size, as bundles, which was quite cool. So that's handy if you're sharing them with other people. So let's take a little bit of a look at the facts and information. So this actually launched on August 27th of this year, and the developers included 5 major folk, and they're all from decent company backgrounds. And even Stripe CEO Patrick actually tweeted out a few days after launch. So if you're looking at competitors, so initially I thought the competitors would be MailerNote and Notion, but MailerNote still doesn't have a native iPad application. But I'm probably thinking GoodNotes is more of a competitor, but GoodNotes does have document management, better sketching, and a cheaper price of $7.99 one-off. Now, what I would say is it doesn't look as good as GoodNotes, despite the name, but it's a GoodNotes-style iPad application trying to compete with MailerNote. Now, I definitely think Muse has got its place in the market. I just think it's still a little bit early in terms of application. So I'm going to give you a bit of a rundown of what the rating is. So for design, I gave it a strong 9 out of 10. For features, I gave it a 4 out of 10. I do think it should have some more features, although I guess some of the feature sets are growing, seeing as it's early days. The pricing, I would say, is a 5 out of 10, so it definitely takes a dent with the features and the pricing. In terms of usability though, I'd give that a 9 out of 10 because the gestures and navigations were really gorgeous. And my own opinion, still early days for this application, but the pricing and features do let it down, so I gave it a 6 out of 10. Now, putting that through the calculator, we gave that a 6.6, which, if you go on IMDb, is incomparable to Jurassic Park 2, The Lost World, which is a good movie, but if you're just putting it on a Saturday afternoon, it's probably a good one there. So still a long way to go in my opinion, but definitely something that looks good and I'm sure in time will grow. So folks, hopefully you enjoyed this review of Muse. As I said, it's been out for a little bit of time, but you can check out all the links in the description. Thank you very much again to ClickUp for sponsoring this video, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Please do make sure to subscribe and do check out the Keep Productive News podcast, which you'll get daily updates on the latest productivity software. Cheers, folks.